You know, Pfizer says its vaccine for younger children is safe and generates a strong immune response. Here to answer your questions is Dr. Kristen Moffitt, an infectious disease specialist at Boston Children's Hospital. Thank you so much for joining us.
Sure. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I want to talk with some of the details first. How is this vaccine different than the one that's available for adults?
So the biggest difference with this vaccine really is the dose. It's actually the same formulation of the vaccine. It is a third of the dose that has been used so far in those 12 and older. So those 12 and older have been getting 30 microgram doses, two doses 3 weeks apart, and the 5 to 11 year olds will get 10 microgram doses, two doses 3 weeks apart.
Okay, all right. A lot of parents have been waiting for this news, but we found that a lot have questions, right? So here's the first one.
What are the side effects for children? Maybe long-lasting effects that could also be for children?
Yeah, that's a great question. And I've not seen these data myself, but the press release from Pfizer at least describes the side effect profile as very similar to that in adolescents and young adults. So what might be expected then would still be maybe some arm soreness or redness, maybe some achiness or very low grade fevers for the 1 to 2 days after getting the vaccines. They did make note in their press release that there were no cases of the heart inflammation that has been seen in very rare cases in some children and young adults after getting the vaccine. In terms of longer term side effects, we now know from over 9 months of giving this vaccine to over hundreds of millions of people across the world that there have been no long-term safety signals for these vaccines. We would not expect that to be different in younger children, but it will continue to be evaluated.
Okay. You know, the vaccine, you know, has been authorized for adults for quite some time now, for nearly a year. One parent asked this. They said, quote, why did it take so long to develop this vaccine for children?
That really had to do with the precedent that was put on the safety of this vaccine. The bar for this vaccine being safe in children was very high. They had to start with dose-finding studies, expecting that children were not going to need as high of a dose as young adults and adolescents would. So that took some time, and then beyond that, the FDA asked for the children in these studies to be monitored for even longer to make sure they were safe. So it really gets down to safety taking longer.
Okay, and we talked with one parent for sure who had a question. This parent already made a decision to vaccinate her son, but here's what she had to ask.
I'm just wondering how long we have to wait and what the availability will be and how easy will it be to sign our kids up to get it. I have a 5-year-old in public school and I'm really hoping we can get him vaccinated soon.
Yeah, those are great questions. We would expect Pfizer to submit all of this data to the FDA within the next week or two. The FDA has already said that they will work essentially around the clock to review this data, but without cutting any corners on safety. They're hoping that review takes on the order of weeks instead of months. So it may be by later this fall that this vaccine might have an emergency use authorization. And the infrastructure has been in the works for months already for this vaccine rollout in 5 to 11 year olds to be able to happen in settings like school clinics and even pediatricians' offices. So stay tuned. There will be a lot more data on how and where this vaccine will be available for kids.
Yeah, I'm sure we'll be talking more as time goes on. That's for sure. Dr. Moffitt, thank you so much for your insight as always.
Sure. Good to see you.